today, we look at the tight end position. Senior Cam Jones is the leader of that group. The Eagan, Minnesota native is returning for what he expects to be his third year as a starter at that position. And he says he and his fellow tight ends are excited to finally get the pads on after all the offseason workouts.
We spent a lot of time in the winter in the weight room and running around at 7 o'clock in the morning. It gets a little old and just get that itching to put the pads back on. So it feels really good to be out here flying around again, so it's good.
As for Jones, he has dealt with some injuries the previous 2 years, but he says that's all behind him.
Fully healthy, feeling good. Really attacked the rehab in the offseason, and the body's feeling really good.
And Jones says he looks at himself as the leader of this group that features a sophomore, a junior, and two freshmen.
If I continue to lead, help out the younger guys, and just do whatever I'm asked to do on this team, so just as long as we're doing that, and as long as we all do that, we'll be in a good position.
The group Jones leads includes sophomore Dallas Goddard and junior Mitch Favoda, who both saw significant action last season.
Yeah, you know, I think we got a lot of guys at our position that are ready to go, capable of doing whatever we're asked to do. So having that depth there definitely helps, just knowing that no matter who's in there, we're going to get the job done.
Everybody seems to want to talk about the fact that the Jacks are without Austin Sumner, Zach Zetter, and Jason Schneider. But with that offensive trio being gone, Jones says he's not concerned.
Those are big shoes to fill, but we're definitely going to find guys that we can do it. So as long as we develop depth and find our guys, come fall, we'll be ready to go for sure.
And if you'd like to find out more about what makes Cam Jones tick, you can read Behind the Face Mask, his weekly blog on spring football that runs Fridays on GoJacks.com.
It's pretty interesting. I've never done one before, but something I was asked to do, and figured it was a good challenge to do, so it's going pretty good.
And on Thursday, we'll take a closer look at the defensive linemen, led by South Dakotan Cole Langer.